Okay, good morning children. Today from 6.3 exercise we have completed 6 questions and 7th one. Rajay and Preeti, two students of class 9 together, collected 1000 for the Prime Minister Relief Fund for victims of natural calamities. Write the linear equation and draw a graph to depict the statement. Very simple. How? Question number 7. There are two students in class 9 and they collected money from the society to the Prime Minister Relief Fund for the victims of national calamity. So now I say that Raji of 9th class let the Raji of Raji let the Raji collected money. Collected money be rupees X and Preeti collected money be rupees Y. They collected together. They together collected rupees, that is 1000. As for this problem, x plus y equal to 1000. Very simple. There is no condition given. What condition? How much Rajya is collected and how much Preeti is collected individually, but both of them together collected 1000. So now from the problem we have taken x as a collected money of Rajya and the money collected by Preeti BY. The sum of them is 1000. Very easy. X plus Y is equal to 1000 is a linear equation. Now it is easy to draw on the graph. Okay, next question. Gopayash sold wheat and paddy. Gopaya sold what crop? Wheat and paddy. In two fields of total area 5000 square meters, write a linear equation and draw it graph on the represent the same as this problem. What area to be taken for a wheat sold area B, water X square meters. Next, what is next? Paddy sold area B, Y square meters. Now total area together wheat and paddy is as per problem, according to the problem, what we say? X plus Y equals to how many square meters? 5. There are 5000 square meters. Both are two crops. So if we put x equal to 0, y get 5000. If we put y equal to 0, x is equal to, we get 5000. Then what do we say? From two points, very simple, again telling, put x equal to 0, what happens? 0 plus y equal to 5000. Now the point is 0 comma 5000. Next, put y equals to 0, what happens? x plus 0 is equal to 5000. Yes, 5000 comma 0. By plotting these two points on the graph, very easy to draw a straight line. Yes, next, one more question, that is, the force applied by applied on body of mass 6 kilograms is directly proportional to the acceleration forced by produced in the body. Write an equation to express the observation and draw the graph. You know that Newton's formula, F is equal to ma. A means acceleration, F means force, and force and what is that? Force and mass. Force and acceleration are both directly proportional. Here it is depend upon by the weight of the thing. So here what is given? M is equal to 6 kilograms. So by substituting here, F is equal to small f. I convert this as the small f is equals to 6a. What is that? F is equal to 6a. Simple to make. If a equal to 0, f equal to 0. If a equal to 1, f equal to 6. Put a equal to 1. What happens? F is equal to 6 into 1. That equal to 6, 1 is 6. What is that? Now, if we take it as a y and it is the x, so that 1 comma 6. Next, if we put a is equal to 3, f is equal to 6 into 3, that equal to 6 is 18. Next, 3 comma 18. By plotting these points on the graph, and now we can draw a straight line. Very simple. Next, a stone is falling from a mountain. The velocity of a stone is given by v equal to 9.8 t. Already straight line is given. Now what value we have to find? That is will be later. Draw its graph and find the velocity of the stone for 4 seconds after start. Here the problem is v is equal to 9.8 t. T is equals to 4 seconds given. Now by substituting what we get, what is the velocity is to be obtained by substituting 4 centimeters seconds here. V is equal to 9.8. V is equal to 9.8 into 4. So that equal to V equals what? 48 is 32. 49 is 36 plus 3, 39. 39.2. What is that? Velocity. Meters per second. Right. Now what I write? X 4 comma 13.2. He asked only what is the velocity, but no need to no need to find the points to plot on the graph. Yes. Now, exercise 6.3 is over. Now, going to 6.4. What are the problems in this exercise? Nothing concepts are before 9.4. 9.4 is completely situated problems which are faced in our daily life. One question from 6.4 exercise. In an election, 60% of voters cast their votes from an equation and draw the graph of the data. Find the collection, find the following from the graph, the total number of voters, if 1200 votes cast their votes. See, listen, very easy to do that. Let number of voters who cast votes, be X. The people who cast the votes, their number means voters, number of voters be X, which are cast their vote. Next, let total number of voters be Y. Actually, from the problem, number of voters who cast their vote are 60% of the total voters. According to the problem, X is equal to 60% of Y. 60% of Y. Question is what? The total number of voters. If 1200 voters cast their votes, if X is equal to 1200, then what is Y? From this, what we can write? X is equal to 60% means 60/100 into Y. 0, 0 cancel. 2, 3 is a 2, 5 is a. X is equal to 3/5 Y. X is equal to 3/5 Y. Now, what is X? X means 12. Here I put to X is equal to 12. 1200 is equal to 3/5 Y. Here if I transpose 3/5 to left side, becomes 1200 into 5/3 equal to Y. 3 1 the 3 4 the 12 2 0s. Then Y is equal to what we got? 5 4 the 20, that means 2000. Yes. The total voters are 2000. From 2000 voters, only the cast, the who cast the votes are 1200 persons. Very simple. Now we write that 1200 comma 2000. Okay, next question. The number of voters cast, if the total number of voters are 800, if Y is equal to 80, what happens? If Y is equal to 800, means what? The total voters only 800, the 60% of them, 60% of these 800 cast their votes. So that what I write? X is equals 3/5 into 800. 5 1s are 5, remain 3, 5 6 30, 0. Yes, X is equals to 63 of 48, taking 0. So X is equal to 480. Means what? Out of 800 people of voters, only the people who cast their votes are 480 members. 480 members are cast their votes. Next question. Very simple. Listen me clearly. Next question. When Arupa was born, her father was 25 years old. From an equation and draw a graph of for this data from the graph find. Yes. let the age of Rupa. Rupa B X years. Father's age B what? 25 years old. B 25. It means what? For example, now I take this Y. How should I take this, sir? Now, as per problem, why should I take her 25 years old when she born? Y is equals to X plus 25 I take. Why should I take that? At the age of 25 she born. When her father is 25? Okay. When her father is 25 she born. The born age will be 0. When she born her age will be 0 initially. So that if we put to x equal to 0, y becomes 25. If she completed 1 year, 1 plus 25 means 26. After completion of 1 year, her daughter age, he will be 26. If she completes 2 years old, now it means 22 years old, her baby, his baby, it becomes 27. So that we write y equal to x plus 25. This is what happens. The next two questions are given. The age of the father when Rupa is 25. Yes. When x is equal to 25, what happens? Y is equal to 25 plus 25 equal to 50. When Rupa gets 25 years, her father gets 50 years. Next question. In the same. Rupa's age when her father is 40 years. Actually, y is equal to x plus 25, no? If he gets 40 years, what the age of Rupa? By transposing 40 minus 25 equal to x. 40 minus 25 means 15 equal to x. So, when she was 15 years, his father be 40. Okay. Next. Very easy. We have to read the question well. And by reading, we get to understand. By understanding, it is easy to analyze and write the problem on the board. An auto charges 15 per first kilometer and 8 rupees 8 each for each subsequent kilometer. What happens? Listen me, an auto charges 15 for first kilometer and 8 each for subsequent kilometer. For a distance of x kilometer, an amount of rupees is y. For a distance of x. Yes, write a linear equation representing this information and draw the graph. Write the help of graph, find the distance traveled if the fare paid 55 rupees. how much would have to be paid for 7 kilometers? Listen me. What if you ask me means, auto charge is 15 per first kilometer and each per each subsequent kilometer 8 rupees. Now I should like that the amount has to be paid, how much would I have to pay for 7 kilometers? The distance traveled, what is the term? Let the charge, let the charge paid be, paid be x rupees. Next, let the distance, distance traveled, traveled be y kilometers. Then what is given as here as our problem? First 1 kilometer, first kilometer is not a pain, that is, that here we should take that y equal to 8x plus 7. How we write that? If we travel 1 kilometer, see, 1 kilometer, and then let the charges be paid for 1 kilometer means that is x. Here, for 1 kilometer we should not pay now. Y is equal to 8 into 1 plus 7 is equal to what? 8, 1 is 8, 1 plus 7, 8, 1, 8, 8 plus 7 is equal to 15. For first 15 kilometers, not paying now. Here, an auto charges 15 per first kilometer. If he travels 1 kilometer, will be charged 15 rupees. Very simple to understand that. X means what? What charges should be paid for 1 kilometer? If he travel first kilometer, the total charge will be what? 15 rupees. Yes, distance traveled by y kilometers. Next, one more. The graph finds the distance traveled by the fare is 1555. Now here, 55 rupees is paid by traveling. So what we write here? 55 is equals to 8 into x plus 7. 55 minus 7 is equal to 8x. 55 minus 7 means 48 is equal to 8x. X is equal to 48 by 8. 8 1 is the x. X is equal to what? 6 kilometers is the what you asked? Find the distance traveled if the fare paid by is 55. How much would have to be paid for 7 kilometers? Actually, we have to write that y means the total cost should be paid to the auto. What is that? X is equal to 6 kilometers is 6 kilometers. X means number of kilometers is traveled by auto. Very easy. Next question. What is given? The parking charges of a car in Hyderabad railway station for first 2 hours is What is that? The parking charges of a car in Hyderabad railway station for first 2 hours is 50 and 10 per hour such subsequent hour. Write down the equation and draw the graph and the following charges. Very simple. Here it is. Now what I write here, y is equal to, very simple here, question is, in a railway station, for car parking, for first 2 hours no charge, for first 2 hours rupees is 50 and rupees 10 each subsequent hour. If I, what we say, if I keep my car in the Hyderabad railway station, for first 2 hours I want to pay 50 rupees. If I put the car in the park, for first 2 hours I want to pay 50 rupees. Rupees 50 to be paid. What? For first 2 hours. For first 2 hours. If I put 1 hour, I want to pay 50 rupees. So next, after 2 hours, if it is continued to keep there, for every 1 hour we have to pay 10 rupees extra. If I want to keep there, 3 hours, I should pay 10 rupees extra. So now what I write, the total number of hours be x and total cost to be paid dy. What happens, y is equals to, now I say that 10 into x plus 20 or 30. Why I say that if I took 2 hours or 1 hour, in 1 hour we have to pay 50, in 2 hours we have to pay 50, so that if we put to x equal to 10 into 2 plus 30, 10 to the 20 plus 30 is equal to 50 rupees. Y means the total cost paid. Same as this, y is equal to 10x plus 30. If I want to keep 4 hours, what happens? 10 into 4 plus 30. 10 4 is 40 plus 30. 70. So if I keep the car in the railway station, I want to pay 30 rupees for 4 hours. For first 2 hours 50, and for 2 hours 10 plus 10 means 50 plus 10 plus 10, 70 rupees. So very easy. Next, what is that given? There are some questions given. For 3 hours, for 6 hours, how many hours did Rekha park her car? If she paid 80 as parking charges. Very simple. Okay, one more question. Here, the ratio of molecular weight of oxygen and of hydrogen oxygen in water is 1:8. Set up the equation between hydrogen and oxygen and how draw its graph from the graph. Find the quantity of hydrogen if oxygen is 12 grams and the quantity of oxygen if hydrogen is 3/2 grams. Very simple. Hydrogen is to oxygen equals to 1:8. The weight of hydrogen is asking when oxygen is 12. H by O equal to 1 by 8. The hydrogen is given, oxygen is 12. H by 12 equal to 1 by 8. The H is equal to water. For 2 is 8, 4 3 is 12. H by 3 is equal to 1 by 2. No? If transpose 3, that side H is equal to 3 by 2. That is equal to 1 by 2 grams. Oxygen is 8 grams. Mercury into hydrogen becomes 1 by 2 grams. Same way, next question. The quantity of oxygen, if hydrogen is 3 by 2 grams, hydrogen 3 by 2, H by O is equals to 1 by 8. Hydrogen 3 by 2 by oxygen is equal to 1 by 8. By transposing what we get, O becomes this side and 8 becomes 8 into 3 by 2 equal to oxygen. 2 1 is 2 4 is 4 3 is 12. Oxygen weight is equal to 12 grams. Very simple. In a mixture of 28 liters, simple question. In a mixture of 28 liters, in a mixture of milk and water, is 28 hydrogen liters. 28 liters. Next, the ratio of milk and milk is to water is 5:2. It means what? If the milk is 5 liters, water will be 2 liters. Then asking water, set up the equation between the mixture and the milk. Mixture and the milk. Milk equation. Yes, now I say that the milk means M, water means W. But here mixture is also said there. The total mixture will become water, 5+2. Mixture is equal to 5+2 is equal to 7. Actually, the mixture is 7, milk parts will be 7. So mixture and milk, that means 7:5. Mixture and milk. Draw its graph. Now 7:5 is equals to what is given in a mixture of 28 liters. No? 28 liters mixture is given. Now it is not given that taking gas. Milk is not there. Now what I write, 7 by 5 is equals to 28 by milk. 7 1 is 7 4 is 28. Milk becomes to this side, if we cross multiply, milk into 1 milk is equal to 5 4 is 20. So whenever if we write the equation as a milk, mixture into milk, mixture is to milk, mixture is to milk. Okay. Very simple, one more question. F is equal to 9 by 5 C of O. F is equal to 9 by 5 C plus 32. In USA or Canada, temperature is measured in Fahrenheit, and in Canada it is Celsius. See, draw the graph of the above linear equations having Celsius on x-axis and Fahrenheit on y-axis. Celsius on x-axis and Fahrenheit on y-axis. this is an equation. If temperature is 30 degree Celsius, C is equal to 30 degrees, what is F? Simple, F is equal to 9 by 5 into 30 plus 32 by 1 by 6 are 9 6 are 54 plus 32 equal to what? 5 into 58 6 86 degrees for a T. If the temperature is in 30 degrees Celsius, it said in Fahrenheit, that is 86 degrees Fahrenheit. Same way, Fahrenheit is given asking Celsius. F is equals to, what is that? 95 degrees, what is C? Now, F is equal to 95, right here. 95 is equals 9 by 5 into C plus 32. By transposing 32, 95 minus 32 equal to 9C by 5. 5 minus 2, 3. 9 minus 3, 6 is equal to 9C by 5. By transposing the coefficient, 63 into 5 by 9. It becomes a reciprocal. 9 1 the 9 7 the. C is equal to 7 into 5. 35 degrees. When C value means the heat in Celsius is 35 degrees, it is equalized to 95 degrees Fahrenheit. How do we write? 35 degrees Celsius is equals to 95 degrees Fahrenheit. 35 degrees Celsius is equal to 95 degrees Fahrenheit. Same like this, very simple. Now we have one more exercise, that is we should do that in one more. What is that? More period. Okay.